Hello guys, today we'll be talking about the book summary, book notes, and review of the book The Productivity Project by Chris Bailey. Okay, The Productivity Project, Accomplishing More by Managing Your Time, Attention, and Energy by Chris Bailey, is a very practical and engaging exploration of productivity. After graduating from business school, Bailey spent a year conducting experiments on himself to discover the most effective strategies for becoming more effective and productive. The book is a culmination of these experiments, offering readers actionable insights and tips to help them accomplish more while maintaining a healthy balance in life. I invite you to join my email newsletter for you to receive free book reviews like this and summarized tips from top mentors on how to live life to the fullest. Just visit kevinumali.com. So here are the big ideas from the book Productivity Project. Number one, the productivity formula. Bailey introduces a simple but powerful formula for productivity. Productivity is equal to time times attention times energy. According to Bailey, true productivity is achieved by optimizing these three variables rather than focusing solely on time management. He argues that it's not just about working longer hours, but also working smarter by managing your time, rather your attention and energy effectively. I agree with that. So before, we thought that productivity is just about productivity management, and it's like about being like a machine continuously producing from X time to X number of time. So let's proceed to the rule number three. One of the core strategies Bailey advocates is the rule of three. Each day, identify three main tasks or goals you want to accomplish. By focusing on just three important tasks, you avoid the overwhelm that comes with long to-do lists and ensure that your efforts are aligned with your priorities. The third idea is managing energy, not just time. Bailey emphasizes the importance of managing your energy levels to maintain productivity. He explores how factors like sleep, diet, exercise, and stress management can significantly impact your energy and consequently your productivity. By paying attention to your body's natural rhythms, you can schedule tasks that require high focus and creativity for when your energy is at its peak. Yeah, my take on that is we, as part of the nature, we go through cycles, and we can notice that there are moments that we are at the peak of our energy and then there's a need for like recovery. So find that peak where you have the most of your energy and use that time if you would like to be productive. Next idea is the attention management. In today's world of constant distractions, managing your attention is critical. Bailey suggests techniques such as the Pomodoro technique, single tasking, focusing on one task at a time, and reducing the distractions. Turning off notifications to improve your ability to focus deeply on important tasks. I've read the book Indistractable by Nir Eyal. It's more of like this one. So identify your traction for you to identify the distractions. Remove everything that moves you away from that traction so you can have more time and more focus on your real objectives. Next idea is the power of saying no. Bailey discusses the importance of saying no to tasks, commitments, and distractions that don't align with your priorities. By being selective about where you invest your time and energy, You can focus on what truly matters and avoid spreading yourself too thin. I can relate this to the lessons from Warren Buffett and Elon Musk. They both suggest that you really, really can focus if you can say no a lot. Not only on other people, but might as well on your other goals that could be a distraction to your main goal. Next idea is the procrastination and the motivation. The book delves into the psychology of procrastination and offers strategies to overcome it. Bailey suggests breaking tasks into smaller, more manageable steps, using rewards to motivate yourself, and understanding the reasons behind your procrastination to address it more effectively. In the book Atomic Habit by James Clear, he suggests that if you would like to strengthen your new habits, you have to use the power of rewards. Let's proceed to the next big idea. It's the experimentation and personalization. Bailey encourages readers to treat productivity as a personal experiment. What works for one person may not work for another, so it's important to test different strategies, track your progress, and adapt your approach based on what yields the best results for you. Next big idea is the technology and tools. While Bailey acknowledges that technology can be a powerful tool for productivity, he also warns against over-reliance on apps and gadgets. He advocates for using technology mindfully and only when it truly enhances your productivity. I myself, there are times that after reading a book through my Kindle or my phone, I still buy the physical copy of the book because it helps me to become more focused in rereading and studying that book. Now let's proceed to another big idea, and that is mindfulness and reflection. Regular reflection is key to sustained productivity. Bailey recommends setting aside time to review your progress, assess what's working and what isn't, and make adjustments as needed. Mindful practices such as meditation can also help you stay grounded and focused. Again, I invite you to join my email newsletter if you would like to receive free book reviews to your email and some summarized tips from top mentors on how to live life to the fullest. Now, these are the book notes from this book. The Productivity Pyramid. Bailey visualizes productivity as a pyramid with three levels: the time, attention, and energy. Time is the base, attention is the middle, and energy is at the top. All three levels need to be managed effectively for peak productivity. Next one is the biological prime time. Identify your biological prime time, the time of day when you naturally have the most energy and focus. Schedule your most important tasks during this time. And it differs from different people. Alex Hormozi said that there is no unique like habits or procedures that make a people or a person become successful. Because even if different rich or ultra successful people, they have contrary habits, but still they are successful and happy and rich. So it really differs from each and every one of us. Next one is the impact of intentionality. Being intentional with your time, attention, and energy leads to greater productivity. Set clear goals, focus on high impact skills, and regularly review your progress. Next one is the importance of breaks. Taking regular breaks is essential to maintaining energy and focus throughout the day. Bailey recommends working in focused bursts followed by short breaks to recharge. Again, we are part of the nature and we can observe the nature that it goes through cycle. And part of that cycle is having some breaks. So spend time or allocate time for you to have rest and breaks. Right. So this is the conclusion of this book. It is a comprehensive and practical guide that offers valuable insights into how to manage your time, attention, and energy for maximum productivity. Chris, the author, experimental approach and emphasis on personalization make this book stand out in the crowd that filled the productivity literature. Whether you're looking to accomplish more at work, balance multiple commitments, or simply make better use of your time, this book provides actionable strategies to help you achieve your goals. If you're serious about improving your productivity, The Productivity Project is a must read. Here are some of the impactful quotes from the book The Productivity Project by Chris Bailey. Productivity isn't about how much you do, it's about how much you accomplish. So it's like output based. The most productive people invest their energy into the right things at the right times. Time management is a misnomer. The challenge is not to manage time, but to manage ourselves. Going back to the lessons a while ago, it's also about managing your attention and your energy. Next one. The rule of three is simple. Every morning, fast forward to the end of the day and ask yourself, when the day is done, what three things will I want to have accomplished? Fifth, energy is the fuel you need to be productive. Without it, you're going anywhere. Energy is the fuel you need to be productive. Without it, you're going anywhere. By working on autopilot, you spend less energy and attention on trivial discussions, freeing it up for your most important tasks. You don't need to maximize every second of your day to be productive. Focusing on the most important tasks is more important. Saying no is one of the most powerful productivity tools you have. The best way to make use of your energy is to work on your most important tasks when you're naturally most focused and energetic. The more intentional you are with your time, the more productive you'll be. Technology should enhance your productivity, not detract from it. Procrastination is not a character flaw, it's a habit that can be broken. Busy work is the enemy of productive work. You can't do everything, but you can do anything you set your mind to if you manage your time, energy, and attention well. Working less can make you more productive if it helps you focus on what truly matters. Breaks are a necessary part of productivity, not a deviation from it. Motivation is like a muscle. The more you use it, the stronger it becomes. Productivity is about working smarter, not harder. Your productivity depends on how well you manage your time, attention, and energy, not just on how hard you work. Single tasking is the best way to get important work done. When you reflect on what's working and what isn't, you can make better decisions about how to spend your time. The more distractions you can eliminate, the more focus you'll have for what really matters. Your most productive day isn't the one where you do the most, it's the one where you make the most progress on what matters. Productivity isn't about cramming more into your day, it's about getting the right things done. To be productive, you must be willing to experiment with different strategies and adapt as needed. Every minute you spend planning saves 10 minutes in execution. Sleeping is the foundation of productivity. Without it, everything else crumbles. The most productive people are those who set clear boundaries around their time and energy. Productivity isn't a destination, it's a journey of continuous improvement. The most valuable tasks are often the hardest to start, but also the most rewarding to finish. So that would be all for this book summary. Again, I invite you to join my email newsletter to receive free book reviews like this. Just go to kevinomali.com, and don't forget do subscribe to this YouTube channel, hit that the like button and notification bell. So see you in my next video.